Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brothers and sisters. May the peace and blessings of Allah Almighty be upon you all. Highly recommended to be fasting on this day, the day of Arafah. And in fact, according to the correct opinion of the people, the scholars, it is the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, wherever you are on earth. One might say, what do you mean? Well, wherever you see the moon, there are differences of opinion, and I don't mean to belittle any opinion, but according to the majority of scholars, it's the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, wherever you are, considered the day of Arafah. So if you've seen the moon before the people in Saudi Arabia saw the moon, and that has happened in the past, probably will happen sometime in the future, today might have been your day of Eid. If that's the case, it's haram for you to fast. How can you fast when you've seen the moon prior to the people in Makkah and Medina, and they have declared the Eid a day after you? In that particular case, you fast according to your own calendar, the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah. But nowadays, mostly people see the moon either with Saudi or after Saudi, with Makkah or after Makkah. And so still, the majority of scholars feel that you should follow the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah. There are some who say you should follow the day of Arafah. Like I said, if you are following the day of Arafah in Makkah, you are not covered the day you see the moon before them. People haven't thought of that, have they? And it has happened. I recall the last Ramadan, there were some countries that saw the moon before Makkah. And those who were following Makkah were stumped mid-wicket. They didn't know what to do. They had to come back and say, wow, well, we saw the moon. What do we do now? Well, the hadith says, you know what? You've got to fast. That was for Ramadan. Anyway, like I said, that is actually differences of opinion. To be honest, it's minor. It's not a major thing. But the day of Arafah, whether you're following the opinion of the 9th, which I follow, or you're following the opinion of Arafah or the Arafah of the people of Arafah, and I told you, the point there is one day when you see the moon before them, you will be stuck. But it's okay. There is no big deal there, because subhanAllah, there are mountains of scholars on both sides. So that day, to fast it, expiates the sins of this year and the next year. So say I've arrived today, I'm fasting. If I'm fasting for the sake of Allah, when that fast is accepted, all the sins I committed in 1441, forgiven. All the sins I will be committing in 1442, forgiven. Which sins? The minor ones only. Subhanallah, not the major ones. The major ones require specific tawbah. Specific tawbah. So that's a virtue of this day. You fast on this day, subhanallah. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Subhanallah. Remember to ask Allah to forgive you, and all of us, remember to ask Allah to free us from hellfire, for this is that day. Jazakumullah khair. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.